It has been noted that insurance fraud is on the rise. According to a report by KPMG that was published in Financial Times newspaper, this vice is on the rise because of the failure of the insurers not keeping tabs with the agents. Welcome to another show of Business Recap. In this particular episode, we are going to look at that reputational risk and how it's affecting insurers and intermediaries.
As he tries to look for it.
In February 2016, Ernst & Young Assurance Tax and Transactions Advisors reported that insurance penetration in Kenya would experience a double growth in the next 2 years. Well, this remains a matter of wait and see, because as it stands now, the insurance penetration in Kenya stands at about 2.79%.
Kenya has higher insurance penetration than Nigeria, almost triple. Now, penetration is not the only way to measure insurance. You can look at density of coverage and numbers of premium. But the markets are very similar. They both have mature risk management. They both have stronger regulations than other countries. They have the innovation and they have the appetite to innovate.
The insurance penetration in Kenya will in no doubt be determined by the performance of regulators, insurers, banks which have taken up bank assurance, agents and brokers.
We all earn a commission. We earn a commission, both insurance agents and insurance brokers. But the major difference is, into the law, agents are classified under insurance companies, and brokers are classified as more independent people. So you find like, when they try to talk about an agent, they talk about an agent of an insurance company. But when you talk about a broker, you talk about a broker being independent and not being under a company. But I can go ahead and say it's created a lot of controversy or a lot of hardships for the insurance agent. Because you find not all agents are actually under insurance companies. And not all, and those who are not under insurance companies are not brokers.
According to London-based insurance experts, insurance sector in Kenya requires a lot of streamlining to curb fraud cases. It might shock you to note that insurance premiums in Kenya could be around 20% lower if it were not for fraud.
There's been a lot of disconnect between insurance companies and insurance agents. Especially because insurance companies do not refer back to the insurance agent to find out what kind of a client or a customer you've brought to the company. Some agents will go deliberately to, for example, cause fraud or to perpetrate fraud because they scheme with a certain client that they're going to insure a non-existent car, and then after some time they say the car is lost or stolen.
We found that the financial sector is heavily beaten by this fraud bug.
This is actually brought about by the insurance company not actually properly liaising with the insurance agent.
As the blame game continues, the bankers are convinced they have the solution that will increase insurance penetration in Kenya. Bank assurance is getting a foothold in the Kenya insurance market.
It is us, the bank assurance, because it is the new way in the industry to change the way this business is done. Let's change the way we do insurance, from even the way we approach the customer, such that a customer who gets a windscreen, you know, the only reason why actually a customer who gets a windscreen claim will have to go maybe for some inspection or will have to see a claims, you know, like a claims, almost a claims adjudicator, it's because of trust issues, right?
Well, there are several main differences in the battle of insurance agents, brokers and insurers, but it's now crystal clear that the elephant in the room is all about a trust deficit gap.
We are sometimes feeling some cold because we are feeling left out by the people that we trust most. We have been working with most of the insurance companies, and most of them are we have lifted them from kama vile tunaimba wimbo ananitoa chini ananiweka hapa ananiinua juu. We have done that with most insurance companies, but at some point they are feeling these guys now are a nuisance. These guys now we still can do without them.
It is such perception that is holding back growth of Kenya's insurance sector.
The bad blood is brought about by agents, by insurance company actually mistreating agents, so to speak. What do I mean by that? Agents, for example, do genuine business, they don't get their commissions.
The developments in IT are the working wonders in all fields of activity. Some of the problems that insurance companies face can be totally ducked with the use of technology.
So we need, as insurance companies, you need to focus how quickly the information is transferred from your point of sale to the core system. Now, there's no need for the customer to walk out of the office. A policy can be issued with applied loading or with any medical requirement, medical questions. The policy can be issued there and then at the branch. And there is consistent decision. You have a routine. You have better data. You have better data analysis. And your mortality rate and everything increases and becomes better because of technology, but resulting to faster decisions and increased sales.
The insurance regulator in Kenya has in the past registered insurance agents for failing to comply with the licensing requirements. Agents have now formed an association to address such issues in future.
The Bima Intermediaries Association of Kenya is basically an insurance agents association. And the main reason why the association was formed was basically to take care of the agents' welfare. Like I've just told you, agents feel they're mistreated by insurance company. So they're mistreated, where do they go to? Before the association came in, they had nowhere to go to. So what do you find? You find that every agent who feels mistreated in the industry actually leaves the industry and goes to do something else. That's why we had in the years 2013, 2014, 2015, you had agents leaving the industry in droves. And the numbers and the records are there. Going to do something else entirely different. But we believe, since the entry of the association in 2014, we are addressing the main reasons and the concerns agents are having. So before they leave the industry, we want to find out, is it something that we can solve?
Insurance penetration is basically the ratio of the total premium underwritten to the country's gross domestic product in a year. Globally, the average insurance penetration rate is at 6.5%, meaning that Kenya is below par. With a change of guard at the helm of the Insurance Regulatory Authority here in Kenya, many insurance agents, brokers, and even insurers are hopeful that the insurance penetration in Kenya will change for the better. Time now to have the Nairobi Stock Exchange update from our business reporter, Robert Bell.
The capital markets is a key driver to the achievement of Vision 2030's goal of a 10% GDP growth rate year on year. The Nairobi Securities Exchange, NSE, has recorded a 5% growth rate for the year thus far, led primarily by the tourism sector, which signals a vote of confidence in Kenya's tourism proposition and security in the coastal region. Now, the bond markets led the way, recording a 50% year-on-year growth, and local participation being at a very high level of 94%. Now, this is a key metric for the NSE, as across all counters, foreign investors account for 70% of participants. However, this year has not been all roses for the NSE. It has seen a number of shockwaves due to global activities such as Brexit and the recently concluded US presidential elections. But perhaps the biggest shockwave experienced at the NSE this year has been due to the enactment of the Banking Amendment Act 2015, which sought to cap interest rates. The banking counter suffered a 30% loss due to this enactment and has only gained 5% since that point. The NSE is, however, optimistic as it seeks to launch several innovative products next year. Now, this comes on the heels of the NSE being awarded the most innovative African securities exchange by AI Exchange. A number of products include, one, the launching of a derivative market, exchange-traded funds, and the flagship product of M-Akiba, which is a government-sponsored mobile bond. It will be interesting to see if the launch of these innovative products along with strategic activities such as NSC Investment Challenge, can spur more local participation. And I'll leave you with the quote of the week. How many millionaires do you know who have become wealthy by investing in savings accounts? I rest my case.
And that marks the end of our show. Thank you so much for watching Business Recap. Let's keep the conversation alive online at WTVK, at It's Elijah Mwangi, at Robert Afugana. Let me see you again next week.